All right, hello everyone, and welcome to session two's SPSS video. Molly just left us, but she was here before. Okay, since Molly left, I have brought you Max. Max is my smallest cat, and also the dumbest because she challenges all of the bigger cats in the neighborhood through the windows of the house and gets them angry. All right, so today we're gonna start off by opening up the SPSS file we created last week. So wherever you save the file, open that up. And you should see that you still have those four variables that you created. All right, what we're going to do with these today is we're going to look at their descriptive statistics, just like we learned in the lecture video. Now, there's a few different ways you can do this. The simplest, quickest way is from within variable view, you right-click on a variable and you hit descriptive statistics, and it just runs them all for you. Now, this only works if you have correctly specified what kind of variable it is, right? So we can see here that for our percentage score on a statistics test, we've got an average of 64.71, a median of 67, standard deviation of 19.7, and then here is our range. The other way that you can run descriptive statistics, and this one is better because it gives you more options, is to hit Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then Descriptives. Click on that, and then you've got a similar pop-up to what we saw last week. We're going to do these one at a time since they have different levels of measurement. So if we pop in our percentage score on a test, into the box, we can request what specific descriptive statistics we want. So it doesn't run all of them. If you hit options, you can specify what you want. You'll see that the mean, standard deviation, minimum, maximum is already selected for you. You can also ask for the range if you want. But the most important thing here is that it also gives you options to see the kurtosis and the skewness, so you know whether the variable is normally distributed or not. So we're going to also select both of those options to see. I'm going to hit continue, and then we're going to hit paste so that our syntax window pops up. We select the syntax, and we run it. And we get this longer table now with a lot more information. So again, we've got the range, same as before, the minimum and maximum, same as the table above, the average, etc. But now we've got this extra information here with the skewness and the kurtosis. And you can see that the statistic value here, so the first column under skewness, is negative 0.391. For the kurtosis is 0.077. Now, the rule of thumb is that if your skewness and kurtosis values are between positive 1 and negative 1, then your variable is normally distributed. So we can look at these and say that yes, this variable is normally distributed because the skewness score is between negative 1 and positive 1, and so is the kurtosis score. If we go back to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and Descriptives, we can select one more option. And that's this one here, the little checkbox, Save Standardized Values as Variables. What this does is it saves your variable percentage score on the statistics test as standard scores or Z scores. So let's click that and see what happens. So make sure this little box is checked off and hit paste. Find your syntax window and run it. All right, so you don't see anything in your output. Where you're gonna find this new thing that you did, the standard score, is in the data window. So you can see now we have a fifth variable called ZStats test. So it's the Z score of our stats test variable. If we look at the data view, now we can see all of the values here. So it's taken these raw scores and turned them into Z scores for us. Standard scores is the other word for it. And what this can actually allow us to do is check for any extreme outliers. If you remember from the lecture video, in the Z score distribution, the normal curve, the mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. So the rule of thumb is if a Z score is higher than 4, then it represents an extreme outlier. Remember from that normal curve that we looked at, 99.7% of scores are going to be within 3 standard deviations of the mean. So if we have a Z score of 4 or more, that means that raw score is more than 4 standard deviations away from the mean. That is very, very far away from everyone else. And when doing data cleaning, you might consider removing scores like that from the data because, as we've talked about, they will impact your average, and they will also impact your standard deviation because the standard deviation is calculated from the average, right? So it can also be influenced by what are known as extreme outliers. All right, so we have now created the descriptive statistics for the continuous variable. You'll notice here, though, that we don't have that interquartile range. So there's one more place where we can get even more descriptive statistics, and that's analyze descriptive statistics, and the same thing that we used last time, frequencies. So select that one this time. If we move our percentage score on the test within the empty box, and then we select statistics, we now have additional options that we can select, including that mode that we can look at, as well as our quartiles, and that can give us our interquartile range. So just select it all, just so you can see what it looks like. Mean, median. And we hit continue. And we're gonna hit paste because we like having a record of everything that we have done. We'd look back on, and we will run our syntax. The frequencies provides you with the information in a table that looks like this. Just same information as before, but divided like this. So now we've got our interquartile range. That's this 50 here, 67.5. And we've got our, that's not the interquartile range. That's the 50th percentile. The interquartile range is the 75th percentile minus the 25th percentile. So you would have to take 75.50 minus 49.50, and that'll give you the interquartile range. Again, we've got the same minimum and maximum as before, the same skewness variables as before. It just gave us those extra percentiles. How you choose to run the descriptive statistics is completely up to you, as long as you present all of the information required for assignment 2. Let's look at assignment 2 very quickly. So you have to create those descriptive statistics for each of the 3 variables that are actual variables within the data set. And I provided you with a sample table of how to present all of that information in one table, basically. All right. Let's do the next variables then. So we go back to our data file. We hit analyze. We hit descriptive statistics. And now we're going to hit descriptives again. We will kick this one out and select the next one, current stress levels. Current stress levels is ordinal. So the only things that actually make sense for an ordinal variable are none of these, right? So for ordinal variables, calculating the descriptive statistics from this window doesn't make sense. It's much better to use the one under analyze, descriptive statistics, and then frequencies. So again, kick it out. Put in current stress levels, and now you have those extra options for median and mode. So we're going to kick out the mean because that doesn't make sense. Quartiles don't make sense. Standard deviation, range, minimum, maximum, skewness, kurtosis, none of that makes sense. The median barely makes sense. So we'll include it for now. We hit continue and we hit paste. And then we can run it. And here it is. So our median is one and our mode is one. If you'll remember, one means slightly stressed. So as we can see also from the frequency distribution table, most of our participants in this sample are slightly stressed. But we can do the same thing for the last variable, so descriptive statistics, frequencies. And kick this one out, put this one in. Since they're both nominal slash ordinal, we could have technically run them together, but this median doesn't make sense for nominal data, right? Because there's no order to it. So all we can do for nominal data is that mode. And we hit paste. And we run it. And ta-da, here it is. So our mode is one. More than half the sample has taken a statistics class in the past. So for this week's assignment, what you have to do is run these descriptive statistics, create a table to present the information using APA formatting, which I've modeled for you here. And then you have to answer the following question about the distribution of the continuous variable. Save your output and submit it along with the text document to Brightspace. As always, make sure you frequently save everything you do. Output week two. And put that in the proper place so I know where to find it again. I'll also save my syntax in the event I need to go back and redo something. It's easier if you've already got all the code ready for you. And then you can close out of those. And I'll also make sure I save my data file because I've got now the standard score, which is a new variable, so I can see that there's no outliers. Or extreme outliers, I should say, within my continuous variable. And that's it for this week. Very quick.